SEGA. Hey everyone, this is Prince Bright Star and welcome back to Phantasy Star Online 2. Tanabata, the Star Festival. The story of two lovers, Orihime and Hikoboshi, separated across the Milky Way by their parents because they would slack on their family duties. Orihime is represented by the star Vega, while Hikoboshi is represented by Altair. On the seventh day of the seventh month, if Orihime finish their weaving, and if it is not raining preventing the bridge of magpies from forming, they would be allowed to meet. This date is based on the lunisolar calendar, which is about a month behind the calendar most people are familiar with. In 2016, it is celebrated on August 9th. In Japan, this event is celebrated by hanging written wishes on bamboo, which after the festivities is then either burned or floated on a river. However, that's not why we're here today. The yearly crossover event has begun, and today two game series that started just days apart from each other have now come together. I never thought I'd see the day when Phantasy Star would cross over with Final Fantasy, but here we are. The primal known as Odin has invaded Phantasy Star Online 2, and while there isn't anything specific for Final Fantasy XIV players yet, producer Yoshida has mentioned that they will be returning the favor in the future. However, their production schedule is what's holding them back from releasing anything right now. So, given doing only one mission wouldn't be enough content, I wanted to take a look at things from the other side. That's right, I've had a character on the Final Fantasy XIV servers ready to go for some time to take down Odin. I want to say hello to him, but before we do that, there's something I need to do here. Unfortunately, Square Enix has some pretty strict policies related to putting video content out. So let me go ahead and apply this to the video right now. And with that done, let's go ahead and say hello to my character on the Exodus server of Final Fantasy XIV. Yes indeed, I play an Aura Paladin, but you can play any class with one character similarly to Phantasy Star Online 2 in Final Fantasy XIV. We're here at Earth's Gift, the place that leads to Earth's Font where Odin resides. Now Odin is a figure based on the Norse god by the same name from the Kingdom of Asgard. He rides upon the mighty horse Sleipnir and wields the mighty blade Gungnir. Now Final Fantasy XIV is a more traditional MMO, relying on the trifecta of tank, healer, and damage dealers, and as a paladin, I go in as a tank, or rather an off-tank. Let's head in and I'll talk you through the fight as we go. Okay, so I'm in here as the off-tank, and basically it's my job, if the main tank happens to go down, to pick up Odin. As you just saw, it used its first ability there, Valkna. This is a point-blank AoE attack that you just have to get out of. His Sanctal ability is a tank buster. What that means is it's designed to do high damage to whoever is tanking the boss. Hall of Stone is another AoE that you just need to get out of. Later in the fight, it'll apply additional telegraphs. Okay, Odin is starting to apply his room-wide attacks. Once again, just get out of the telegraphs. And really, that's how a lot of Final Fantasy XIV is. You just have to get out of the telegraphs, and you'll avoid damage. this Ire Jar is a room-wide AoE that healers just have to heal through. Okay, these red circles here. He's about to summon down a bunch of spears. You don't want to have the circles overlapping. Okay, now with the spears on the ground, we need to take out these Gungnir, as they're applying a constant bleed to everybody in the room. Okay, at this point, you've pretty much seen everything that Odin does. As you can see, his attacks become more complex over time. But that's the basis of this fight. Okay, looks like we just lost someone, but a healer is getting them back up. That was a really complex one. I almost didn't have anywhere to go there. Here comes another tank buster. And as you can see, that takes Velocidon down to half health. Okay, the Gungnir are on the ground again. Let's go ahead and take these out. Okay, Odin is moving to the center of the room here, and he's casting this Shin Zantetsuken. If this attack goes off, it's going to wipe the party. So at this point, it's just a burn phase. We have to take Odin out now. And down goes Odin. In the aftermath of defeating Odin, it's learned that his blade does not disappear, and so it is captured for study. Upon securing it, however, one of the guards steals it away and takes it for their own. This leads to some confusion until it is mentioned that what may have happened is the blade itself is a part of Odin's essence and would have the same ability that other primals would have to bend mortals to its will. But anyway, with that fight done, let's now head back over to Phantasy Star Online 2 so we can take a look at the new mission called the Wandering Black Knight. Okay, so we're getting underway here. Couple of things I want to note real quick here about this mission. The first is that healing is greatly reduced in this mission, so you really want to avoid taking hits. And secondly, all the items are going to drop at the end. And it looks like we're up against some Dragonkin here first. We've got Garongo, Rappy, as well as some Oceanids back there. Well, one thing I'm noticing immediately here is the fact that the battle music is not playing, which tells me SEGA did not put this into the sympathy system. Okay, over here we got AIS Exoda. These guys are from the 4th Tower Defense mission. It looks like we've got an Anga Fundarge up next. Here we got more Darkers. Once again, when you're dealing with a party of 12 players, enemies are gonna go down real fast. Let's try a sacrifice fight. More Darkers. Ooh, I am getting bounced around a lot. Okay, moving on. Oh, there's the battle music. And it looks like we've got a False Angel here. And I've been shocked. Okay, we definitely don't want to be hit by those. Looks like somebody went down. Let's go ahead and pop them back up. Ooh, that's a lot of damage. Let's try to heal up as best we can. As you can see, we are getting very little per tick here. Okay, let's get on Luther. Okay, down goes Angel. Let's head into the next area. Oh, it looks like we got a restoration pod right here. And here's an Iza Ogar. Once again, going down very quickly. Oh, we got some Barbillipan over there. As well as Darkers from the Ultimate Forest area. Trying to confuse me, huh? Here's an Anjadu Lili. Unless you're able to get him on the side, it's very hard to take him down. Alright, on to the Anushi Zagri. And that clears up that group. I believe I see some rock bears here. switching to my wired lance. Gotcha. Actually, I don't think I got yet. As you can see, that Barbillipan is actually a small Lillipin that got transformed. Okay, what's up next? Looks like it's a Gar Zigmor. Let's go for an overhead. Okay, let's heal up. Let's try that again. Over it. We are healing for so little in this mission. Let me try a Dimate. Yeah, even doing that is not doing much for me. Okay, now that the Gar Zigmor just used that attack, we gotta take it down quick. And down it goes! Completed. There's another recovery pod, and this teleporter here is taking us to a new area. And as you can see, we have arrived in the Black Shroud. Now once again, for Odin, it's going to be a DPS race here. So I'm going to try to unload as quickly as I can here. And there he is! Alright, let's pop the critical field and let's get going. And here come the telegraphs. Let's get out of these. Let's use Anti to get these players out of the ice. Let's try a sacrifice bite. Didn't do too much. Oh, nice launch. Okay, here come more telegraphs. Oh, he dodged my overhead. Let's try that again. Overhead. Oh no, you don't. You're not getting me. Oh, he launched me, but I kept going on my over end. I'm frozen. Gotta heal. Alright, he's going for his final attack now. We gotta take him down fast. And down he goes! And just like in Final Fantasy XIV, his sword is still here. Okay, let's go ahead and pick up everything that dropped. Alright, and let's head on up back to the camp ship. So the really interesting thing about this is, even after this event ends, Odin is not leaving. He is going to be available as a random boss that can pop up at any time inside the game. And when he does, it actually looks like you've joined a fate from Final Fantasy XIV. Now, brief background on that. Fates are basically semi-random events that can pop up in the game world that are accessible to anybody in the area. The thing that's kind of fun about fates is if you're too high of a level for the area and you join in on a fate, you actually can't participate until you level sync yourself down to the appropriate level for the content. Obviously, that's not going to happen here in PSO2, but it's still an interesting way of introducing Odin to an area when people aren't expecting him to show up. Anyway, thank you for joining me today. This is Prince Bright Star signing off. I'll catch you next time.